Hey guys, you're Worker Prison, welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool Chrome, where last time I left off, I start off Season 3 of the career mode. I did it in spectacular fashion against Stoke, being 5-0 in my first Premier League game. Only matched the 1-0 win over Crystal Palace in the second game, but the main thing is that I did indeed win that match, instead of dropping points, which would have been bad. This is the first League Cup game of Season 3. It's against Brighton, as you can see.
It's cup tie time in the English
Looking
League.
For three consecutive League Cup trophies in three seasons, and this will be the start of the road to achieving that. And no better place to start that road than Anfield.
In the 1-0 win, clean sheets are great, and the strikers can score. I think they will win today again.
And that road to final stop will be at Wembley if all things go well, which they should. Some new youngsters in the squad today in central midfield.
In the English League Cup.
Well, but mostly the side is players you've seen before. Other than Renato Sanchez and Mario Götze, I didn't really sign anyone new, and penalty straight away, just after the third minute. I'm not even gonna try to pronounce this dude's name because fuck him. He should have an easier name to pronounce if he wants people to fucking try and pronounce it. Alexander Arnold is stepping up. Absolutely no one is good at penalties on the second team. I'll give it to Diwak because he is the striker here. Well, it's not a good penalty, but the keeper stood in the middle like a dumbass. So Diwak Origi opens the scoring just before the 4th minute mark. It's 1-0. Not the best penalty, but again, the keeper stood there like he wasn't even bothered. Like, he kind of stepped over to one side, like he was about to go to that side, like he was about to dive to that side, but then he realized Origi was going the other way. And by then, maybe it was too late. Maybe that's, I don't know. I'm clutching at straws to try and figure out what mayhem, and just say, oh, fuck it. Yeah, we're 1-0 now.
So the first goal is 1-0. Goal for Liverpool. 27.
Yeah, but anyway, not a good start for Brighton. Great start for me, but neither here nor there.
That throw has literally tossed possession away.
Brighton going for a bit of a long range world, and didn't quite work out as the player would have liked. There's Emre Moore.
In comes the challenge. And that's a turnover to the opposition.
Two Brighton players managed to get the ball off of him.
To stretch the opposition using the wider areas here.
That's going to be a foul against Henry. Yeah, Brighton player, despite letting Henry help him up, is not very pleased with the foul, I'm guessing.
And There's the interception.
Why he brushed him off, despite the fact that he left Henry help him up.
It's a shot now! Terrific stop! Well, stuck out a foot and cut off the pass. Into the attacking third.
Well, can you?
And in goes the cross. Caught under no challenge by the goalkeeper.
Straight into the hands of the Brighton keeper, Stockdale. That goes all the way through or for it.
Now.
And Murray Moore. Can he score a second goal? Oh, that was a shot. I might have had a better chance of scoring there if I had actually produced a good shot from my opportunity, but that's not what happened.
There goes the cross.
Fayor.
Good progress with this attack.
I was hoping that would miss the defender, but defender intercepted the attempted.
Position, but it could be worse, of course.
The cutback pass. This into the box to possibly, hopefully, lead to the second goal. He was alert to what I was trying to do. Reggie loses the ball. Brilliant! I just don't... No, because... I mean, I could hold the contain button, which is how they protect how you use... Tell your player to protect the ball as best they can. But to do that in the opposition's box just seems like it's more of a thing you do with defensively, even when you're trying to clear the ball away from your own box, not down in the opposition's box when you're trying to work your way into a scoring position and to make it to not to you.
Actually how well they played in that first half. They'll be delighted. They'll need to try and get the ball back now. They'll get a free kick for that.
The referee's giving a free kick. Okay.
Now you can cross it.
Again, the same defender as well. Well, if you notice, it's actually the guy who gave away the penalty. And I wonder if he's trying extra hard just to try his best to make up for the penalty.
Moving forward with some danger to the opposition. Now they're here. And now they've got the chance to push forward from this deepish position. Substitute coming up for the away team.
Well, I was the brain manager. All the defensive work in the world didn't make up for the penalty as long as the scoreline was reading
around that figure anyway.
That we were losing. But then again, I'm not the Brighton manager, I'm the Liverpool manager, so I'm winning, so I don't give a shit. Origi, this time the ball across the box is there, but Moore makes an absolute mess of it. Well, I say Moore, I mean me. He has to share some of that blame as well. I mean, that wasn't... Yeah, he didn't catch it cleanly, but still, That's beside the point.
That's a good spot by the defender. Here's a chance to attack. A timely challenge.
More. Here we go. Oh, this time Emery doesn't make any mistake this time. He makes it 2-0 this time. I'm going to stop saying this time.
It is certainly the kind of match that we thought we were coming here to see with the better team.
Making up for his past as misses and failed attempts. Since Emery Moore or Barry he's it and makes it 2-0. So both strikers are off the mark in the League Cup this season. And Diego Origi are got off the mark with that penalty. And now, Emery Moore has made it 2-0.
A quick note for your diary. Make a note of this.
Here you can see the game on the schedule for the 1st of September. Thursday, played a returning Aston Villa. But yeah, they are back.
It's going to be a substitution.
He got for two season absence.
Here's Emery Moore.
He might be It'll be after the window is closed. I don't think I have any signings planned, so it should be a relatively quiet end to the transfer window. So I don't know if anyone is going to try and sign Emery. I've weirdly not gotten any offers for him.
They decided to make a change.
That were at least if I have, they were not in any way acceptable. I find it hard to believe that no one has
they should win now, shouldn't they?
Is interested in a second from midfielder. I find that very hard to believe.
They've certainly done the job out here, and I'd be confident of doing it again in the next one. There's some potential in this move. Good play. But they've lost the ball now. The opposition could get at them. The flag's up.
I mean, if he's... You can see him there. Alright, so... Yeah, alright, good enough. If he's still here, or come September 1st, I mean, I can play him.
Attacking now.
He's mostly not in the team at the moment, because, you know... I don't know if the if it works like real life where the team might play back if there's a one-way player in the team. So I don't want to have to deal with that. Hello? Is this guy gonna take the throw? Is he's waiting for the goalkeeper. Wow. He waited for the goddamn goalkeeper to get back to the goal. Never mind that you're on the clock here. Yeah. Genius move from that guy taking the throw. Oh, and you wasted time, you fucking moron. Arsenal drawing Wolves. Champions Cup. Wolves, Spurs, and Manchester United are one of all. Well, I don't know which would be better for PSV 5. You told me you wanted to leave, man. So, piss off. Coutinho, look. Coutinho and Laforte.
Walsall 1 after extra time. Bournemouth 1. Rotherham United 2. Cardiff City 4. Barnsley.
Not Emery Chan.
Gillingham 0.
So.
Blackburn Rovers 2. Ipswich Town 0. Preston North End 1. Leighton Orient 2. Aston Villa 3.
I don't know what to tell you. What?
Middlesbrough 3. Port Vale 2. Northampton Town 3. Bristol Rovers 2.
Match rescheduled.
1. Plymouth Argyle 1. Plymouth Argyle won 4-3 on penalties. Norwich City 1. After
probably a few matches just got rescheduled. And I'm going to take a wild guess that might have something to do with the. Oh wow, Aubameyang to PSG. That might happen in real life because Aubameyang has come out and said he is apparently leaving Dortmund in the summer. So everyone's expecting him to go to Real Madrid, which is a big possibility. Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised by that. But maybe PSG. Maybe PSG will say, here, we have money too. Not that anyone has forgotten that. PSG, they love to remind everyone of that at every chance that they get. What was I doing? Oh yeah, I was going into the calendar. Derp. That's why I went into the calendar. Lazio, so an Italian team. Atletico Madrid and who the hell are these guys? Okay, so these are obviously the scrubs of the group. Lazio and Atletico Madrid and SK Rapid Wien. Who? The fact that I don't even know them straight away doesn't scream I should take this team seriously. At all. That's an interesting look to the February schedule at the moment. Leicester's my last game of the season. Oh, it's on at home. Get through this deadline day as quickly as possible. That just skyrocketed up. I don't know why. I'm assuming that means someone may be getting up signing. Musonda the Bayern Munich. 22.5 million, that's pretty good. Good considering. I guess that's Bayern Munich's way of making up for the lack of Kingsley Coman. Because they play in the same position. Oh, 6 hours left. I have an email. It's an offer for David from Spurs. Nope, that's not happening. Even if I was looking to sell David, I would not sell to Spurs. Cardi goes to Manchester City. I've got another offer before. 4 minutes remaining. Four hours. I said minutes. PSG want Daniel Sturridge. Okay. Maybe we can work something out here. Uh, Yeah. Let's see if PSG feel like splashing more of that cash. Let's see if they feel froggy after their purchase of Aubameyang. Do they want to smash the record? Or to this particular window set by Dahoud going to Barcelona? I'm kind of hoping that will turn them off because I don't have time to get in a replacement. Maybe I should have gone for 100 million. Okay, it's not looking like this is going to happen. And this time I am going to go for 100 million. But let's see, you can double my balance. Okay, PSG, 143.5 million. So, I'll be waiting patiently, looking at the bank account of the team to see you agree to that. Imagine if they actually did. I mean, it was never gonna happen, especially because they turned on the opportunity to buy him for 85.5 million. They were never going to spend more. They were like, why would we do that? Oh, this is much better to spend more money. Hey, Mohamed Salah going to Real Madrid? Half a fucking billion. Over half a fucking billion. God damn it. And what's sad about that? It's realistic. It's the amount spent overall. Half a fucking billion. No, I won't be taking the Irish job. Anyway, anywho, into the game against Villa. I don't know how they've started off on their return to the Premier League. And I just noticed that I didn't get any new month injury fee, which sometimes happens. So that was a stroke of luck. Renato Sanchez's chance to possibly get off the market as a Liverpool player. Our goal scorer so far this season have been, we've only had three. Daniel Sturridge and Mario Götze.
Well, this team has started that chance. I think we all expected them to be at the end of it, but two wins out of two, they've certainly announced their intentions to the rest of the teams in this division.
He could be the star turn for Liverpool today.
Three in his last three.
And there you can see the game is informing you and Villa that they should be on the. They should keep a keen eye on Sadio Mane. Not that they would need to be told that if they paid any attention to the last two seasons.
And the goalkeeper has.
I thought for a second that might he find its way in. Imagine, and straight away Renato Sanchez opened the scoring. Oh, there we go. Oh, a wonder. Similar to what he did in the first. Will score a wonder goal to announce himself. Well, that is how you will score your first goal for the club. Go into the position and saw the opportunity. Did it? It looked like it hit the post there on the replay, didn't it? No, it went clean in. Why? It kind of looked like it just took a little nudge off the post. So it's not enough to, you know. I mean, if it had taken any kind of contact off the post with the power or not the ball, it would have flown over to your side of the net. Yeah. So, must have completely avoided the post. I don't know why it looked like it. Anywho, Renato Sanchez becomes the fourth man to get his name into the onto the goal score sheet for the for season 3 so far in the Premier League. It's 6 different players in total if you include the goals from Emre Moore in the cup as well. But I'm talking about league goal scorers. Renato Sanchez. And the ball is not going to be picked up by anyone other than the goalkeeper.
And excellent control in a tight area.
I mean that figuratively. Not literally, like the keeper did literally pick it up.
Now they're here.
Oh God, the end of it.
No problem. Oh, he's lost the ball. And the referee says, free kick. Daniel Sturridge.
Sam.
And they've cut it out.
Yes. Firmino picks it up.
He's pinched it back again.
And loses it. Brilliant. Come on, Firmino, for God's sake.
And that's one for the goalkeeper, I think. Played it back to him. McCormack. Got the ball back, the interceptor got it for them. Could be dangerous.
Mane! I don't know why I went for the chip. Why did I go for the chip? I should have just smashed it into the goal for without a second question.
Interesting to see what footwear the teams are going to actually use today now that this rain is coming down. Might have to change what they originally started with.
Yeah, and I think sometimes with the lads wearing blades these days, you do see them slipping a bit more. And
Manny.
They have to change
halfway
through this match.
Attacking now.
Oh, I thought Renato Sanchez would muscle his way into the ball, but not to be the case.
But it's a pretty slender margin at this stage. We've got half-time coming up, and they want to get there with this lead still intact.
Here's Renato Sanchez. Sadio Mane loses the ball. God's sake.
Two consecutive victories into
Götze. Sturridge.
Well, he's treaded the
Roberto Firmino. Trying to work his way to the position. Nathaniel Klein. Renato Sanchez. Coutinho!
Liverpool have won a corner.
I saw the little pocket of space. I thought I could squeeze it in, but Bunn was equal to it. And Mane's header from the corner is awful. Sorry, Sadio. I can't give you praise for what was an awful header. Normally I'm the first to give you a praise, because normally you're much better than that.
At Anfield, the second half is now underway. Jordan Ayew. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. And he's got the ball away from him with the tackle.
Let's say. This is how team. This team can play. Mane. Great passing. Being put on by the players. It's come to the Sturridge! Oh, is it the post? Coutinho! There we go! Oh, Phil Coutinho gets his name on the score. Actually, not sure why he's shushing the... but it's his first goal since being given the armband.
With a fine goal. Was a good goal. And it came at a crucial time, I think, for his side.
Right under the keeper. Very nicely done by the magician.
Just widen the
as he becomes the fifth different player to score from the was the third league game.
Aston Villa going to make a change here. Liverpool will get the throw. Daniel Sturridge stopped emphatically and just as well. The approach play looked very encouraging. McCormack.
David Alaba.
Some players limbering up.
Not the best of a pass.
We've reached the hour mark. Half an hour to go.
Yes. Marta Sanchez and Mario who collectively worked together to get it back. Oh, and Renato Sanchez's touch to try and put it into a perfect position for him to possibly score a second goal. Well, it was too heavy and it took it straight to Bun. Here's Renato Sanchez again. Loses it.
Still got the ball, still progressing. And it's a shot now!
It's over the bar from McCormack.
The part to play now.
Keeps it going. They can get one back now.
Oh, good save from Karius. It's the second really good save he's pulled off this so far this season.
That's a splendid clearance.
Oh, Sam! He's going to be 1-1 with the keeper! This is like the worst position for Villa. Oh, they missed! Man, they missed! Sadio, since when do you miss? 1-on-1 as well. I don't know what to say about that.
Time ticking on. Just
Renato Sanchez. Well, isn't... Yeah, Sturridge is freaking tired. Firmino is tired. They're all tired. What is going on? Why? Why are you all so tired all the time?
Here, it's the goalkeeper's ball. Liverpool want to make an alteration. They're going to bring a new player on. Quick note for your diary, make a note of this particular date. EA Sports, we've got the presentation of the Premier League fixture.
Gotcha. Liverpool. Hey. Gotcha. Trying it! Oh, it's good! He put in by Daniel Sturridge. No, he's offside.
I like the look about Liverpool today.
It was put in by Daniel Sturridge, but it's not going to fucking count.
The win that they deserve.
I didn't even take any notice of the linesman. This time it's in though, and Sadio Mane didn't miss this time. He scores his fourth goal of the season. He's in it's an instant impact from sub Marco Grujic, which was instant assisted. It's goal number 3 for the game. That truly kills off the not having any kind of hope of salvaging something from this game. And that is Like I said, it was a 3-0, and that is the really kill their blow.
Fernando Barrientos. There's good progress with this attack. Makes the challenge here. Here's Emery Moore. It's a quick break.
Rigi. For wrong goal. Oh, is he going to score? Yes, he is. People go Rigi. See? His first... with his first contribution of the game after coming on.
In you go.
It's a goal for himself. Oh, very nicely done. But Daniel Sturridge is a stamina issue. Excuse me. Maybe the opportunity is there. There for Diego Corriki to get himself back into the first team. It was poor performances that led him to be overshadowed by Daniel Sturridge in season 1. And that was even before the injury. I might start Diego Corriki in the next Premier League.
Cropped up. Could be dangerous.
We'll see.
And it's a headed effort.
Renato Sanchez, he scored again!
And it's there for Liverpool!
Renato Sanchez bags himself a second goal. Oh.
Liverpool have got the goal. The defenders seem to lose the concentration almost. They saw it coming.
Well, he had to fight for it, but
they're a powerful side and they really do attack the ball with a lot of aggression.
After getting one, he's gotten another. And he hugs him or for that brilliant cross. Matos. And his makes quite the impact when he...
5-0.
After breaking his duck, he then snapped the duck's neck.
And, that's a win confirmed.
And why I used that particular wording, I don't know. Sorry for putting that image in your head. It's just ran after Sanchez.
Derby County 1.
Anyway, on that odd note, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you're subscribed if you're new. Until next time, I hope you all have a very nice day. Peace.
1. Leicester City 2. Southampton 2. Manchester United 2. Swansea City 0.